Imagine a TV so advanced, it doesn't just show you the future, it is the future. This is the self-powered TV, an invention by Maxwell Chikumbutso that doesn't need electricity because, apparently, cords, plugs, and power outages are a problem for the mortals and not visionaries. This isn't just a TV, it's a clap back to the entire energy industry. Picture your average television but with the ego of a superhero. It doesn't just work, it thrives even when the rest of the neighborhood is plunged into darkness. Get ready to laugh, marvel, and maybe question your own appliances as you delve into this hilarious and ingenious world of this blackout proof wonder. Imagine this, the power's out, the neighborhood is in chaos, and people are wandering like zombies looking for their phone chargers. Meanwhile, you're in your living room, snacks in hand, catching up on your favorite TV series like The King or Queen of Resilience. Maxwell Chikumbutso's self-powered TV, a device so bold, it doesn't just laugh at blackouts, it thrives in them. This TV doesn't have wires, it doesn't have plugs. What it does have is a built-in generator that somehow powers it without making so much as a beep. Think about that for a second. A television that runs on, well, magic? Probably. Chikumbutso claims it's powered by a hybrid engine technology, but we all know what's happening here. Wizardry, divine intervention, or aliens sharing an ancient trade secret. But don't let its unassuming appearance fool you. It looks like your standard flat screen TV, but beneath the skill exterior lies a genius piece of engineering that scoffs at your electricity bill.
This is our self-powered TV that we have designed. The first in the world to have such kind of a technology where a television is powered with a radio frequency. So as you can see right now, I'm powering this television.
There are no blinking lights screaming, high tech. It's quiet and humble until it rolls to life while everything else in your house sits useless. Your fridge, warm. Your microwave, useless. Your self-powered TV, still spilling spoilers and looking as smug as ever. Now, let's talk about the functionality. This TV is a survivalist dream. Heading off-grid for a camping trip? The self-powered TV says, I got you. Planning a protest against power companies? Just set it up as your glowing centerpiece. It doesn't just work in the absence of power. It revels in it. This TV thrives on making generators and power banks look like relics of the past. And here's the kicker. No one really knows how it works. Maxwell tossed out some terms like hybrid engine tech and self-sustaining power source. But let's be honest, if someone said it ran on hopes, dreams, and a little bit of cosmic energy, we'd probably believe them. It's like someone dared him to reinvent the wheel, and he said, fine, but I'll make it float. While everyone else is sitting over their monthly power costs, you're sitting pretty, knowing your TV doesn't owe the grid a single volt. It's not just a win for technology, it's a win for your wallet, and to be honest, for humanity. Now let's talk about Maxwell as an individual and as an inventor. Maxwell hasn't just invented a self-powered TV, he's invented a self-powered vehicle and even a self-powered helicopter. But what do all these devices have in common? That one device that is invented. And the name of the device is the Microsonic Energy Powered Device. This device is so powerful that it captures radio frequencies. I mean, apart from Maxwell having dreams about his inventions, because you know Maxwell obviously is not an engineer by profession or has never studied engineering. But all of these inventions that he has, he claims that they were from a divine intervention. He claims that God came to him in a dream and gave him all these inventions. And while scientists have disapproved of his inventions for ages, Maxwell still insists that they work. Yeah? So the Microsonic Energy Powered Device is so unique that Maxwell can't even share what it does. Because to be honest, no one really knows what this device does, except convert radio frequencies into electricity.
This Microsonic Energy Device, this box, this is the device that is converting radio frequencies into pure energy.
But I have to say, there might be some truth in what Maxwell does.
This is a generator. I think if you can go to the fridge, you can see He's going to plug in and you'll see that fridge is going to be powered by a car. Like I said, you can buy a car. You don't need to have a generator at your home. You use your car.
Even though I know the skeptics obviously are against this, because Maxwell was apparently poisoned. Yeah, he was actually poisoned for this invention. Because who does that? Is it because he's a threat? Is this invention so legit because him being poisoned? And get this, he wasn't poisoned in Africa. He was poisoned while he was in the US, because he had to take his invention to the Western world.
It is called a microsonic energy device. A microsonic energy device, it is the generator in this machine.
So while he was in the US, Maxwell got poisoned. And his partner, being his first investor who believed in Maxwell, unfortunately, he succumbed to the poison. Maxwell's inventions have been heavily criticized over the years. The main argument being, his inventions defy the laws of aerodynamics. Using radio waves to convert them to electricity really doesn't make sense, right? Because it's like basically converting air into electricity. Although radio waves are everywhere, you know, like in your routers, in your phones, you know, maybe even the device you're using right now, they all use radio waves. But how did Maxwell achieve this? Because it's something that scientists all over the world, Thomas Edison, Einstein, they've never been able to do this. But Maxwell from Zimbabwe somehow did it. And the thing is, Maxwell's inventions have been tested. Like, there's a time Maxwell invented a generator that used nothing but radio frequencies. No fuel.
Test is successful.
It's not screws.
Oh, that's 217.
0.9.
That's perfect.
We get it.
So that's the 18 batteries.
Yeah, that's the 18 batteries.
So that's higher than the nominal voltage.
Dude! Wow!
Thank you so much.
That is awesome.
That's the 18 4-volt batteries. So it has higher voltage.
Thank you.
Give us two thumbs up.
Thank you so much.
One final check of the battery voltage revealed a shocking result.
So engineers from the US came and confirmed that the generator actually worked. Yeah? So how do you disapprove such a thing? So let's talk about his cars. Since the beginning of 2025, Maxwell has been making headlines. And it's mainly because he was hosted by the president of Zimbabwe. And while he was being hosted by the president, Maxwell actually demonstrated how his cars actually work. And what's surprising is, Maxwell revealed that he'll be selling his first car.
So which products do you have on the market?
The car? I remember that this car doesn't use fuel, solar. It just uses air. Of course, radio frequencies.
The vehicle, it uses what we call the microsonic energy device. The microsonic energy device, it is the device that I personally invented in 2009. Which harness radio frequencies, convert it into energy.
But what Maxwell has really done is take his device, the microsonic energy powered device, and built it in a larger scale such that it can power a TV, a generator. So to Maxwell, his opportunities are endless. Because with this microsonic energy powered device, he can basically even power a jet. But truth be said, if this is a con, then it is one of the biggest cons ever in our generation. Because being hosted by the president is something that is, I mean, mind-blowing. And him being the first person to create energy from the air, I just can't believe it. But as we speak, his inventions are actually available for purchase.
So which products do you have on the market?
The car?
Are the batteries on the market?
The greener power-grid machines are on the market, the TVs are on the market, the bikes are on the market.
An invention that goes to the extent where the inventor's life is threatened is something worth looking into. And there's the conundrum. Maxwell claims that he can't show us how his device really works. And it's because his ideas will be stolen. Because they're currently not protected under, I don't know, like some copyright laws for inventors or something.
So is the microsonic device? What we have done, like we said, the microsonic energy device is the invention that we have done, and we are trying to protect it. We have embedded it in the vehicle.
Okay.
Yes. and it has got a self-destructive technology. On the 150 wires on this car, if you try to tamper with five of them, would be classified. You destroy the Microsoft getting device, both of the software and the hardware. That's how we're protecting the technology.
So there you have it. The self-powered TV. The sassiest piece of technology to ever grace our living rooms. It's bold, brilliant, and blackout proof. A triple threat, thus redefining what it means to stay plugged in.